How to diagnose heterotopic pregnancy. It is most of difficult, challenging situation how to reach diagnosis in a case of heterotopic pregnancy. First of all, to assess uterus and to assess confirm presence of intrauterine gestational sac, not pseudosac. If you do this, don't stop at this point. You should look for Douglas Bausch. If you find fluid, even small rim, it may be normal finding, maybe due to rupture of ovarian cyst, or it may be due to rupture ectopic pregnancy. We should assess both hepatorenal Bausch or upper abdomen for presence of any collection. Presence of any collection in this area raises suspicion of presence of heterotopic pregnancy. Then assess both adenexins. It's very important to look for ovary on both sides and presence of any lesion besides the ovary. Here, there is a lesion which has a sequel, not a picture of the ovary, and anechoic area inside it. We should raise suspicious of ectopic or heterotopic pregnancy. This is intrauterine pregnancy and this is an ectopic of heterotopic pregnancy. This is a strange case of a triplet pregnancy, intrauterine and another ectopic pregnancy. The most challenging in diagnosis of this lesion is differentiation from ectopic pregnancy from corpus luteum. We may find intrauterine sac and we look for adenexin, we found rounded structure, which is corpus luteum, and maybe regard it as heterotopic. It's not heterotopic. How to differentiate between corpus luteum and ectopic or heterotopic pregnancy? First, corpus luteum is located within the ovary and surrounded by normal ovarian tissue. We look all surrounded by normal ovarian tissue, unlike ectopic pregnancy, which may be adjacent to the ovary, not surrounded by ovarian tissue. Corpus luteum move with the ovary, with manipulation. Corpus luteum typically does not have thick echogenic wall. Wall is thin, but in ectopic pregnancy, we have thick echogenic wall or ring. Unfortunately, car Doppler or pulse Doppler cannot differentiate between corpus luteum or ectopic pregnancy.